Hello everyone. So in the previous video we have seen introduction to Servlet. Now let us see with working with Servlet. Let us see a practical example how to do a program in Servlet. I am Professor Dattatray Gandhmal from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So let us begin with this particular video, working with Servlet. So what students will be able to understand after this video, they will be able to identify various Servlet API, demonstrate simple program using Servlet. So these two things are the outcome of this particular video. Let us quickly begin with Servlet API. So what is Servlet API? Servlet API is nothing but a package used for creating a program in Servlet. So it's a package. So what is package? Package is nothing but which is a collection of classes and interfaces, in short. So now there are two Servlet packages. One is javax.servlet.star and second one is javax.servlet.http.star. Okay, so these two packages. So why this servlet.star is going to where it is going to be used? It is going to be used for any protocol, not to any specific protocol. It can be used to any protocol, maybe HTTP, FTP and so on. Whereas javax.servlet.http protocol, this particular package we are going to use only specific to HTTP protocol. So whenever I am interested in HTTP protocol, I'll be using this particular package. Okay, I think this slide makes sense. javax.servlet.star and javax.servlet.http.star, these two packages we have in Servlet API. Next, what we have in javax.servlet package, we are going to see various interfaces present inside javax.servlet package. So these are all the interfaces present inside javax.servlet package. So what are they? Servlet, servlet request, servlet response, servlet config, context and so on. These all 14 interfaces we have inside javax.servlet package. Similarly, classes inside javax.servlet package, these are the various classes present inside javax.servlet package. Generic servlet, servlet input stream and so on. So these are 11 classes present inside javax.servlet package. So basically a package contains classes and interfaces. So we have seen interfaces and now we are seeing classes. Next, moving on to next package, javax.servlet.http package. What are the interfaces present inside this particular package? So they are specific to HTTP. So they are prefix with HTTP, HTTP servlet request, HTTP servlet response and so on. Okay, you can pause anytime and make a note of this particular interfaces and list of interfaces. Next, classes in javax.servlet.http, these are the classes inside it: HTTP servlet, cookies, request wrapper, response wrapper and so on. So based on need, we will be using those classes. So these are all ready-made classes and interfaces which are present inside API, which help us to do the servlet program. Next, over here I request you to pause the video and try to list down Servlet API. So just pause for some time, rewind the video and answer this particular question. List down Servlet API. Okay, welcome back. So answer for this particular question is javax.servlet.star and javax.servlet.http.star. So these two packages or two APIs we have inside Servlet API. Okay, next, directory structure of Servlet. Very, very important slide. So directory structure, when you are creating a Servlet program, you cannot directly write a dot servlet file and do it. Here we have to follow a structure. Web app, inside web app we have a web INF folder, inside web INF we have a classes folder and lib folder. Inside classes we have a class files and inside web INF we have web.xml. Make a note of this. Green color indicates folder and orange color indicates files. Web.xml is also a file. Okay, so anything resources you have, you directly can keep inside web app root directory. Okay, please make a note of this. Next, we'll quickly start with the actual program. So moving on to, we need a servlet file, right? So for that, let's go with servlet program. I have already created a demo servlet program. You can make a note of this demo servlet program. It's a demo servlet.java file. You can directly copy paste this particular Java file, type as it is, and Let's say I want to, I'll copy this particular Java file into one folder. Let's say I'll copy this into E drive. Okay, now I need to compile this particular thing. So come to command prompt and go to E drive, Java C demo servlet dot Java file. Okay, demo servlet dot Java file, compile. So once you compile, a demo servlet dot class file will get created. Okay. So here demo servlet dot class file is created. Now take this particular file and where you will paste it. So we have seen here in the directory structure, it should be inside webinf, inside classes. So before that, we'll come down to XAMPP folder. So I'm using here XAMPP. So come down to XAMPP and go to Tomcat. Inside web apps, you create one folder. Let's say I'll create one folder, test 1 2 3. Okay, in test 1 2 3, inside it I need one more folder, right? I need webinf. Okay, inside it I need one more folder called as classes. Okay, inside this classes I'll paste that class file. So all class files will reside inside classes folder. This is clear. Then one more file is there, web.xml, important file. So I have already web.xml file. Copy this web.xml file and come down to that particular folder, test 1 2 3. Inside webinf, you paste it. So what is there in the web.xml file? Let us see. Open with notepad. So this is what we have in web.xml file. What web.xml file is having? It is having a servlet class. What is a servlet class? Our servlet class is demo servlet, right? And servlet name. What is servlet name here? I am giving some dummy name XYZ. That doesn't matter. It should be same up and down because it's a mapping. Second thing, URL pattern. It will call with that particular URL pattern. So I want this particular page to open with welcome. Fine. So first of all, we'll see how to run it. So come down to XAMPP control panel, and here we have Tomcat service. Start this Tomcat service, and I have already started it. You can start it. Once it gets started, go to a web browser. I'll go to Google Chrome. Here you type localhost. Okay, once this localhost is that means when you can see this page, that means it is running. Here slash test 1 2 3 slash welcome. Now this is welcome to first servlet. That means we have successfully executed it. So coming back to demo servlet, what we have written, I'll go to E drive. Here we have a file called demo servlet. What we have written here? Here we have written doGet. Inside doGet, there are two parameters for it, request and response. As we have seen in the previous video, for every servlet, there is a request and we have a response back, right? Now, here HTML code is embedded inside Java, that is servlet. So your HTML code, you will write inside the Java file. So your printWriter is a class for which I've created an object PW. Now println. So this what printWriter is going to do, it is going to write as it is what we are doing in HTML. So here HTML, simple HTML file, HTML body, welcome to first servlet. If you want something else, you can make a change over here and copy all your HTML file over inside this print line, pw.println, and it will execute. Understood. Important things to note down here is javax.servlet.http package I've used. Servlet.star I have used, and java.io star. IO, why? Because I'm using printWriter. Make sense? Next, web.xml. I already told you what is web.xml. See, if you're not able to execute this when you are trying to compile this particular file, demo servlet, and you face problem, in that case, you will face a problem that compiler is not able to locate servlet.http package. When this error will come, to resolve this error, you come down to Tomcat. Where is your Tomcat? Inside XAMPP, there is a Tomcat folder, right? Inside Tomcat, there is a lib. In lib, you have servlet api.jar. This is what we have seen. This servlet api.jar contains all interfaces and classes. So what you will do, copy this particular servlet api.jar file and come to C, then program files, Java, JDK, JRE, lib, inside lib ext. Inside ext you will paste it. I've already pasted servlet API. If you get an error of servlet API, you will paste, do this thing. And definitely you'll get this error, you have to do this step. Okay? I think it is very clear now. Okay, so these are some of my references which I've used to create this video. I hope you understood. Thank you.